Did you say the one and only?
Yes, we said.
Thank God for that, right? Well, good evening, everyone. It's really a great pleasure for me to be here with you tonight, and I'm really looking forward to sharing lots of music with you. I want to thank KO for inviting me here, to Mika, who is always wonderful to be with, and came with me all the way from the airport. And to everybody here, I just want to say a big thank you, because I love what I do, and I do what I do because you love it too. And I'm so thankful for that. As some of you know, I've just been through a really difficult personal situation, and I'm really happy that I can play and sing for you, because then I can sing away some of the sorrow. And it's just been a difficult time, but playing somehow makes me feel better, and I hope it makes you feel better too. As Mika said, I think, I'm going to play some songs for you first, and then he'll take over, and then I'll come back later and we'll play you some rock and roll. But in this part of the show, I want to play you some songs just alone, or almost alone, actually. And then we'll have a chance to, if you want to, you can ask me questions and we can chat a little bit, and you get to know the songs better, and you can get to know me better, and just we'll have some fun. I'll play you the songs exactly the way I wrote them, so you know how they sounded in the end, and I'll just play them now the way I wrote the song, so you can see how the song was born. Okay?
Yeah.
But don't be shy. If you have a question, if you want to ask me anything, there's a microphone somewhere. I don't know where it is, but it's out there somewhere. And they can give you the microphone so everybody can hear your question, okay? Okay?
Yeah!
Right. Just to show you how versatile I am, we'll start with the guitar. I'm going to sing you a little song that you can sing along with me. Now, I think this song was on the Innocent Victim album. I'm not sure, but I know that you know. So if I'm wrong, just tell me. I don't care. From yourself. die. We let it pass us by, though you try to keep me hanging on. But with all this doubt, it'll never work out. So tomorrow tuned down one whole step, and the bottom E string is actually a C.
C.
Yeah, it's mainly set up like that for the wizard, which I'll be playing later. And then when I want normal tuning, I just put the capo on the second fret. So
how does it feel like you are a very special songwriter?
I'm sorry?
How does it feel?
Where are you? It's like a voice.
I'm here.
Okay, oh, there.
Where I like you. You are a very special songwriter. How does it feel you?
What, to be a songwriter or a songwriter? No, thanks for the question. I started writing poems when I was a little boy. Very bad ones. And at some point, I wanted to turn my poems into songs, so I picked up the guitar and I tried to learn how to play it, and then I started playing my mum's piano, not properly because I don't know anything about real music or anything, but just so I could turn my poetry into songs. The instruments became tools to help me do that. I can't play properly, I cannot play guitar or piano properly, I just play in my own way, and that seems to be okay. But for me, writing songs is a great thing to do because I can express my feelings and share them with you, and sharing them musically makes it a lot more fun than just sitting here and saying, oh, my heart is broken, I'm so sad. But if I can sing about that, then it makes it easier. So it's great. To be a songwriter is great. And anybody can do it. You can all do it. It's very simple. All you have to do is just write down how you feel and what you think about something you see or something you hear, and then find a way to put music to it. It's actually really that easy. I think this is on Fallen Angel, I'm not sure. I don't remember. I'm working on a new record for next year. Next year is the 50th anniversary of Uriah Heep. And even though I'm not in the band anymore, and I haven't been for a long time, you know, 50 years of music, celebrating music is a great thing. So I'm making a new album. To release next year, next spring. And I'm doing it for you because I want you to have something new. You know, the record company will give you lots of old things and lots of recycled stuff and everything, but I want to give you something new. So I'm working on an album now of songs. Some you know, some you don't, but in a really different format. And it's just gonna be my 57th album of my life. I've been making records all my life, so that'll be number 57. So if I forget which song comes from which album, please don't blame me. I'm sorry, it's just I don't remember. But I remember this one. Shooting for the moon. Jack, can I get some? Thank you very much. At this point, I'm going to not be alone anymore. I asked for water and I got vodka. It's okay, I can handle it. Anybody have a question? No? Right then. At this point, I want to do...
All right, question.
Get that voice in the dark again. Just a second. These two songs I did on an album last year called Rare and Timeless. I put the demos of these songs on that album. And I'm re-recording them now for the new album next year, which I don't have a title for this album yet. I've got some ideas, but I'm doing them in a very special way. And I'd like to play them for you now because, you know, it's always important to keep moving forward, and I write all the time. So I've always got new material and I just want to share it with you. Now, in case you're wondering who this person is here, this is the lovely Maria Hannanen, who's going to play with me the next three songs. And we're going to do something very special on Monday, aren't we? We kind of wrote a song together, and Maria recorded it, and I'm going to go in the studio in Helsinki and put a little bit of Hammond organ on it for try to do some magic or something. But for right now, she's going to work with me on these two new songs. Now, these songs are very personal and very important, so if you can take time out to listen to the words, that would be really good. The first one is really about the fact that our business can be really cruel at times, and I have a lot of friends who are really suffering, and this song just tells the story of what happens if you don't like see the future and think about the future. And so it's called Dear Mr. Star. Ooh. So let me introduce myself. I am the end of your career. Thank you very much. This is my fantasy.
When I die, I'll die alone.
Okay, this is your last chance to ask me a question. All dressed in black, and it was a lovely windy day in England, like it always is, and her hair was blowing around and everything, and it just gave me the idea for the song. So I picked up my guitar and wrote the first couple of lines. So there was a girl, and she was dressed in black, and her long hair was blowing in the midwinter wind. But she wasn't coming to me, she was going home, I think, or something like that. But so the rest of it was just my imagination. Yeah, that's how it happened. But this next song was written in the studio in the middle of a bunch of sessions with the band. And it's a love song. And one of the most beautiful songs that David ever sang. I mean, his vocal on the original recording of this song is amazing. I can't do it like that, but I'll do the best I can. The band was out. I wrote the song during a break. They came back. I played the song to them, and we recorded it immediately. So I'm going to play the song now for you, exactly the way I played it for them when they came back from the pub or wherever it was they went. It's a love song. I write lots of love songs because it's my favorite subject, or one of my favorite subjects, and I write lots of songs about love and everything, but also it's kind of a song about the English weather.
Why did you
chill. I'm gonna take a little break now. I'll sign everything later, okay? I promise. After the show, I'll be around over there somewhere and we can do whatever you want. No problem. For right now, thank you very much for spending this little bit of time with me. I'm gonna hand you over to 5:15 now and then I'll be back in a little while and we'll play some rock and roll for you. Thank you so much.